G'day trippers, my name is Donato. Welcome to week 8 update of London Marathon training here in Gellevelt Park in Worcester. But let's crack on and give you, as I say, that week 8 London Marathon training update. But before I get into my week 8 London Marathon training update, as I transfer from Gellevelt Park behind me over to Pitchcroft in a few minutes, thank you all so much for the amazing support you gave me on that last week's video. It's been challenging times, but I'm sure it's challenging times for a lot of you who are watching this. And if you are new here, help us all by, or me, and maybe you as well, because you'll feel good by helping me, is thumbs up, subscribe, and all that jazz. And we'll continue giving updates as we progress towards London Marathon and beyond. Let's go. Yes, guys, welcome, welcome, welcome. As I enter the borders here of Pitchcroft Park, in the distance there, where I recorded last week, was at Worcester Racecourse Grandstand, and I'm here again. It's not actually the Monday that I normally do an update. Once again, it's the Friday, so it is literally a week on from last week's update. And what a week it has been. Since I'd recorded, I did complete the on the Saturday, I'd done a nice tempo-ish type run, really enjoyed it. And what was serendipitous is, whilst I was here last Friday, if you watch my addendum of last week's video, I did get to the, is it the beginning or the end, however you want to see it, the Birmingham and Worcester Canal. And on the Saturday, I ran past the other end of the beginning or the end of the Birmingham Worcester Canal. So it's basically closing the loop. And then on the Sunday, as we just seen on my previous video, I completed the Kenilworth Half Marathon as part of a training run. Although I was going a little bit quicker than I should have been, because I was with Mr. Ventilator, or was it Ventilator Man, Kieran, and we had a great run together. How he runs in that outfit, I do not know, at those speeds as well. But well done to him. I'm looking forward to catching up with him. Ooh, gotta watch out for the bikes around here. I'm looking forward to catching up with him at London Marathon. So after that, it was what I would call a sort of not typical week, because it was rest day on the Monday. Tuesday, I had, I think it was 600 meter reps, a series of those, 10 or 12 of those, with some rest in between. And that sort of went well. I'm feeling better. The vertigo is slowly, gradually improving, but it's still there. I'm still waking up with like foggy head, not feeling good in the morning. But I do tend to feel better by about mid-afternoon, by about 3-4 o'clock. And yeah, so that was the Tuesday, and the Wednesday, rest day, and then Thursday, just a 1 hour, relatively easy run. And here I am Friday. Friday is another rest day, but tomorrow, and I might film this, is I have a 5K TT. And I was going to do it at my park run at Cannonhill Park, but that's been cancelled for tomorrow. So I'm looking to find another park run where I can run relatively fast. So I've been looking at local ones, and would you believe the best one, nearest one that I can find that's on like a tarmac service is here. Yeah. So I'll be doing the Pitchcroft Park run. That's the current plan. I don't know. I need to check a few more logistics, because all the other ones tend to be on grass, hills and that. And whilst it's great to still do a park run, 5K, on that, as it's a TT, I need to go all out and see how fast I can go. So I might film it for your delectation, so keep an eye out after this video if I do film it as one, and two, publish it. So that'll be that one. And would you believe Sunday, I actually have a rest day. I got my days mixed up. I thought the Pitchcroft 10K was this Sunday, but it's actually the Sunday after, a week before London Marathon. And that run is not a 2 hour 45. There was a bit of a mix up on my plan, so I checked with the coach who put the plan together, and yes, there was a bit of a mix up, because they were forgetting that I was doing London and Yorkshire Marathon. So my long run training will be the London Marathon. But that's something I wanted to update you on, guys, because this week I had some really exciting news. I mean, so exciting I nearly wet my pants. And it was to do with London Marathon. And if you've been following me on the socials, if you look up Pope with Pace, I'm on the Twitter and Instagram and Facebook and so on. And I posted an update because for me, it's terribly exciting because being a the Abbott's World Majors have introduced something new called the Wonder World Championships, age group championships. So for those who are 40 years and older, depending on what age category you are, I had an email, and here's a copy of that email, where I got entered into the Wonder World Championships. So what's exciting for me is, and I'm undecided, I've almost decided, but I'll update you later next week, because the plan was to have London as a training run. So run at an easy pace, similar to Kenilworth, and then race the Yorkshire Marathon. But having had that email, as I swap arms, having had that email, if I win my age group at London Marathon, I'll be world champion for the Wonder Abbott's World Majors. How cool would that be, eh? World champion! Wow. It's hard to believe how far I've come in such a short period of time, you know, just a relatively few years, from a charity runner for Hibs Lupus Trust to here, England International Standard, and with an opportunity to become world champion at marathon distance at Abbott's Majors. I mean, that's just, for me, that's just insane. I would you know, if you'd ever said this to me when I started running 6 years ago, I would have questioned your sanity, and sometimes I question my sanity, but hey, that's another story. It's quite incredible how things have progressed, and a lot of you guys have been with me from the beginning, and I appreciate a lot of new guys who've arrived literally in the past couple of weeks. There's been a hell of a lot of new subscribers, so welcome to all of you. You're all welcome, whatever age, demographic, standard, it doesn't really matter. And we did have a chuckle, and I think Colin, you did pick up on Dave's comment at the Kenilworth half, where Dave Lockie mentioned that he thinks he's the slowest runner who subscribed to my channel. Is tongue-in-cheek, because he ran a sub-2 half marathon, which was incredible, because Kenilworth is very hilly, undulating, whatever you want to call it, and it was a sunny day. It was tough, but as I walk along here, look at this beautiful view. Oh, look at that. Ooh. I feel like running around the race course, obviously with the horse maybe, but hey, absolutely beautiful here. So it's quite insane really, and for you guys who have been following my journey from this, it's a bit tongue-in-cheek moment, but whilst that's what my plans were, I am toying with the idea of racing, because opportunities like this don't come along all the time, but they're opportunities for what I may be doing at London Marathon, running with Kieran, who's going to go for his Guinness World Records. Opportunities like that don't come along either, so I'll see what it is, but I still think my A race will be Yorkshire Marathon, but I'll update you more next week. I may not decide till the Sunday morning on the 3rd of October whether I go for it or not. I don't know. That's how I roll, yeah. And maybe you guys roll that way. I'd love to hear your comments below. What do you think? Should I race London Marathon and see if I can become world champion in the inaugural Wonder Abbott's Wonder World Championships at London Marathon? And I'm sure they will have others, because someone did comment on the social meds. The challenge I have is getting into Tokyo Marathon, because I think the qualifying time, irrespective of age, is a sub-2:45, and then you go into a lottery whether you get the place. I think if I was to be world champion at the Wonder, I'd get an automatic invite, would I not? I don't know. Tongue-in-cheek, maybe. But yes, a lot to look forward to. As you can probably tell from my voice, I'm feeling a lot more enthusiastic about the future. It's been very challenging, and right now I'm still in the middle of property hunting, where to rent, where to live, where to buy. There's so much up in the air, and as you can imagine, it can be quite stressful, added in with a lot of uncertainties that are going on. And I do appreciate that a lot of you guys watching this are having challenges as well. We all have challenges in life. That's almost part of life, and we overcome those. And I sort of look back at a lot of the challenges I've had, not just over the past year, 18 months, 2 years, but over my lifetime. And I look back on each one and how we've overcome them and how we move on and progress. And sometimes we just, and it's easier said than done. I appreciate it's easier said than done. We just need to go with the flow, not to fight it, not to resist it, but just go with it. And that's what I'm trying to do with my vertigo, is not to fight it, resist it, and take in all the drugs and hopefully it'll all disappear, but allow my body to acclimatise, because it's obviously happened for a reason or whatever. And that's another factor that will determine what I do with London Marathon, because it's literally, by the time you see this, it's less than 2 weeks away. And with the vertigo that's been here now, it's been, you know, I'm still getting episodes. It's been, what, over 6 weeks, 7 weeks. And, you know, when you have that kind of virus in my ear, it affects my health. And for anyone who knows anything about marathons, is you can't cover up any slight health issues or anything, or slight niggles or injury. I mean, I've got a niggle at the moment with one of my calves, and that may determine how I do my 5k TT tomorrow. But you know, fingers crossed I can hold those. But when there's other things that are going on, especially internally, you know, the viruses, our body needs time and energy to heal itself and recover. And if I'm going out blasting a marathon, that can might send me backwards, and that could put me out of the Yorkshire Marathon. So I don't want to do that, because that'll be racing for England. First time racing in an England vest. But so much exciting things happening. I hope you enjoyed this update. That's it for now. Here I am along the River Severn. It is beautiful here. Would you believe that when it, certain times when it floods, where I'm standing right now, I'd be underwater. All of this racecourse is underwater. The River Severn comes right up, and yeah, but right now I'm safe, I'm okay, I'm on this path and it feels good. So thank you all so much for watching this. I hope you appreciated it. Do give it a thumbs up and leave some comments below, and I look forward to seeing you next week, where I'll give you an update of how I've got on with the 5k TT, and maybe some update on decisions with London Marathon Race and how we progress on week nine. That's week nine of London Marathon training. Take care, guys. Love you all. All the best. Bye, bye, bye. Onwards to the river. As an addendum, and I know some of you do like addendums to my videos, I've just crossed the racecourse where the horses go galloping along here. They would come up and up to the grandstand there. I'm at the, I don't know if you can see this, it says 2F, which is 2 furlongs to go to the finish. I've got no idea how far 2 furlongs is, but here's one of the fences. So they're all, you can see all the fences, mobile fences here. So this is, I think, what they call steeplechase horse racing. So this is one of the hedges. I just thought I'd share that with you, because there's the grandstand, 2 furlong point. I can almost feel the horses galloping along here. But yeah, so that's my addendum for this week. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm gonna go. So I don't know why I'm looking, because there are no horses around, you know, to see if I'm crossing the race course, that it's safe. You know, quick, get across before the horses catch me. Laters, guys. See you next week.